Well, we're finally back at the treehouse. It's unbearably hot today, so I'm going kind of slow. What you're seeing here is the first corner board I got put on. What I did with these corner boards is, well, I made them out of 1x6, though I had initially intended to make them out of 1x4. So I bought 1x4 for the corners and 1x6 for the fascia, which you can see up here isn't installed yet. And they sat in the shop for a couple months, and then when I finally got around to making the corner boards, I made them out of 1x6 and used up my 1x6. So now I have a bunch of 1x4 I don't need, and I have to go out and buy more 1x6 for the fascia. But what I did with these corner boards is, get back to the corner board, in the shop, you can see this joint right there, maybe you can't see. They're glued, and I used just about every small clamp I had to glue these up in the shop. And actually, before I glued them, is I ripped this piece so that this combined with this piece plus the thickness of this piece, this width is equal to this width on the face, because I absolutely hate it when they take corner boards and they don't rip one piece, so this piece ends up being, say, it's a 1x6, so 5.5 plus 3/4, and this one's only 5.5. Right now they're both 5.5. That's just a peeve of mine. I think any carpenter who does a corner board without doing that is just lazy and a bum. But enough snobbery. So that's the first corner board. As I walk down here, and I'm going kind of slow because I still don't have decking. Well, I have decking, it's just not installed. Here's the second corner board installed. What I did with the corner boards was, as I said, I glued them up with no fasteners so that I could cut them anywhere. I brought it out here. I scribed to that line, I cut the angle, I primed the whole thing, so the inside, outside, even the ends, the cuts are primed to try to minimize rot, because it is just pine, I didn't go for treated wood. And then on the back side of it, there are two beads of caulking on both faces, and it's sat in, and that's to mitigate water intrusion behind it, which again will help stall off the rot, because we've got the rough cut edge of the T111 behind it. I don't want water getting back there. If I come back around to this side, you can see that's some of the caulking bleed out. So in some spots it bled out a little bit, some spots didn't. I am gonna take this joint here and topically apply caulking to the whole joint now that they're attached, but any caulking that did bleed out in a couple spots, I just rubbed smooth with my finger, and some of it's black, some of it's white. I wasn't paying attention to colors since it's all gonna get painted over. Not that, so. If I come around to this last side, or at least the last side I can reach, this is what the corners look like beforehand. So you see the T111 on both sides and just the joint in the T111. This happens to be two factory edges, but some of them, it was actually field cut. It was rough. And they're all primed like this. So this side I haven't gotten to prime yet because I have to set up scaffolding to prime it, but I did prime around the corner so I can get my corner board on and then keep priming later, because I wanted everything to be primed again to mitigate rot. I want to stop water from getting behind the corner board, and any water that does get behind the corner board, I want to hit primed wood, not rough, bare, freshly cut wood. So that's where we are with the corner boards. I think that'll be it for corner boards for right now, because I've installed this soffit, which gave me something to bring the corner board against. I still have to install this soffit around the back. And to do that, I actually need to put a deck on so I can better frame up here. But before I put the deck on, I think I'm actually going to go buy the 1x6 so I can properly frame the fascia there, because I need to go and get a couple other things. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm not doing it in any particular order. It's too hot to think clearly. I'm taking it as anything I do get done in these couple days over the weekend is just a bonus, because in all fairness, I should be inside the air conditioning. But that's where we stand right now. I don't mean to complain. I know there are people who live in areas where it's much hotter than this. But here in New York, with the humidity, the heat index has been over 100 for about 2 weeks now, and it's starting to get a little old. But that's the treehouse. The going continues to be slow because of the heat. But you can see here is the back face. Here's the soffit yet to be closed off. Here's my first piece of soffit for the back, so I'm working on getting soffit installed.
I don't know if I'm going to take it much further than this today, but I'm at least going to get the soffit installed to the back face.